we've been doing here at Rancho Genesis is ministering to kids who don't have as much as we do and who live in poor communities and who are not exposed to Jesus like we are.
This year we have a community called Durango that we're ministering to. Two of the staff members went around door to door inviting kids and the families to come and join us at this camp. They can't stay the night, but we get to spend time with them during the day. So they come here and we're all paired up with at least one or two kids, and our goal is to just love on them and show them as much attention and love that they might not get at home during this week.
We show them how much we are loved by our God and show them how they can be loved too. A really amazing week where you get to see them open up and have fun, and you get to show them that life could be so good, and even though some things are not as great, you still get to have this amazing opportunity. And even though you can't really speak to them, just through your actions, playing with them and just serving them, they see that love and it really changes their life. And you might not see it right away, but it could change their lives forever.
I really didn't know what to expect. Your parents should be proud of the kids you raise because they're very good with the niños. They love on them, they build relationships, and they do it within hours after getting here when the kids show up. They build relationships quick. These kids, they open up really quick because I think they really seek affection. I think this is pretty awesome to show them that there are people out there that love them. They really learn that God loves them. They learn that there are people out there that care for them. I think the churches that come down here and the things that they do really makes a big impact on their lives.
I've been paired up with a 5-year-old and an 8-year-old, Danya and Leslie, and they're very different, but they both are really, really enjoying this week. I've really connected with them a lot. They've really become great friends to me, and I'm so excited to see how affirmation time goes tomorrow night, because we get time to really tell them how special they are in God's eyes and in our eyes and everything. I think they're gonna really take a lot out of this week, knowing that God is there for them. They have people who love them. They know how valued they are, because a lot of times at home they don't get to get that same affirmation that they get here. I'm sad that we have to leave them kind of soon, but I'm really gonna enjoy today, and I'm really excited to spend the rest of the week with them.
My two girls are named Dana and Rosa. They're 11 and 10, and they're the sweetest things. They are down to do anything, and I just love spending time with them. I'm really excited for affirmation time tomorrow night, where I can hopefully share some verses, some scripture with them, and speak into their life in a different way than just showing them love.
We present Jesus, the healer of our hearts, and we want to present that to the kids and to the amigos. We like when you guys come down and you guys serve with those niños that really need the love of God. So it's really an impact when those niños just leave on Friday or Saturday. They just leave with their eyes like with tears, because they never experienced having somebody next to them, somebody that will spend the whole week with them.
All the job, all the tired, it's
worth it.
It's worthy, yeah.
That's what makes it all worth it, that the time we all spent here together with those niños was all worth it, because they got to know the real love that is Jesus Christ.
piensas ya de Jesús?
Que él está muerto.
Sí.
Él está vivo.
Él está vivo.